Guten Tag, meine Nightingales. Ich heiße Octavius, and I would like to talk to you about my upload schedule here on YouTube. As many of you have likely noticed, my upload schedule is a bit sporadic at best. And honestly, it must be a surprise when a new video pops up. I'd like to explain why this is and why I don't upload more, even though I want to. But first, let me introduce you to Spoon Theory. Spoon Theory was invented in 2003 by Christine Miserandino, an individual who lives with lupus, who, what did you say, chronic illness. While in a restaurant with a friend, she used spoons to symbolize packets of energy and visualize why she had more energy on some days rather than others. The idea is that chronically ill people typically have less spoons or less energy than others, and therefore must pick and choose what to do on any given day. The amount of spoons such a person has is dependent on many things, such as how they slept, pain levels, events, and a lot of things that can really, really vary a lot from person to person. Spoon Theory just absolutely took off, and it wasn't long before thousands of chronically ill people were using spoons to signify how much energy they had any given day. These people were soon calling themselves spoonies and using the term spoons in place of energy. Nowadays, Spoon Theory isn't just limited to chronically ill people. A lot of mentally ill people have been using the term as well, especially those with trauma or those who are neurodivergent. I think you know what I'm getting at here, so I'll just say it. I'm a spoonie. I'm not diagnosed with anything, but there is a very high probability that I am chronically ill. My mother has multiple chronic illnesses and multiple autoimmune disorders that have been identified throughout her bloodline. There's also a very high probability that I'm autistic, as I have sensory issues, and I do a lot of the key autistic things, such as happy hand flaps, rocking when I'm overwhelmed, and going nonverbal. I started using Spoon Theory sometime last year, and I've really grown to like the metaphor and the visualization of energy sitting in a spoon like soup. I imagine that every time I do something, I'm swallowing a spoonful or two of energy soup. Even on days where I may have a lot of spoons, they always seem to drain really quickly, even if I'm not doing much of anything. It appears that just being around people can drain me. And when my spoons drain, I typically go nonverbal in an attempt to save what little energy soup there might be left. Again, very likely that I'm autistic. This is why I don't post videos as much as I'd like to. On the weekends, I just don't have the energy, and what energy I do have, I want to save for school. I'm in my senior year now, and we're already coming up on the end of the first semester, so things have been picking up a bit. I also ride my bike to school, and the area where I live has quite a few hills, so that can also use up a lot of energy, especially on bad days. I love voice acting. I love doing ASMR roleplays. I actually make all my scripts myself, so that's another thing that takes up time and energy. And I love this channel. But I just don't have the energy to do it. And it's not just spoons. My voice gets very worn out very quickly, as I'm not exactly a talkative person on a day-to-day basis, and I typically don't do vocal warm-ups as I should. I also tend to speak very quickly, which causes saliva to build up, and then my words start slurring, and it's like a whole thing, and it's very annoying, so I just don't talk. There's also some vocal dysphoria that fucks me up on occasion, which I won't get into for my own sanity. I'm hoping that once I graduate, I'll have more time and energy to produce things for this channel. I hope to do video essays and story readings, along with roleplays. I've also started to voice train in the form of singing and reading aloud more often, as my violin teacher is also a vocal teacher, so hopefully my vocal dysphoria will kind of ease off as I practice more. As a senior in high school, there's going to be quite a few things going on, especially as we meet the end of the first semester and move into the second semester, then, you know, all the stuff with graduation. I'm sure you know the drill. But unlike a lot of others, I'm not planning on going to college quite yet. If ever. So, no university to get in my way, but there are a few things I'm planning to get done within the next 5 years, so I guess we'll just kind of see how things work out. Again, I really do love voice acting. I hope to have a career in it someday. I do really love being here on YouTube, even if not a lot of people watch my things, but I just don't have the energy a lot of the time. Nor the confidence in supplies, but that's a topic for another time. I'm sorry I can't post more often, I really do want to, and I hope I can start posting more videos once I graduate. I feel it's also important to note again that I write all my roleplay scripts myself, so that can take up a lot of time and energy. But if there is a script you really want me to do, such as maybe one you found on Reddit, please do comment with the link. I am okay with recommendations. And with that, I'm gonna go get a snack and take a nap. May your gods, if you have any, be with you, and until we meet again, Octavius out.